about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, bass. Yeah, it's pretty clear, I ain't no size 2, but I can shake it, like I'm supposed to do. Cause I got that boom boom that all the boys chase.
Okay, hey guys. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm doing this. So obviously this is my senior video, and this is crazy that I'm doing one of these, because I remember my freshman year how they had to do their senior videos, and at first I was like, oh, what is that? And they explained it to me and everything, and here I am 4 years later doing my own senior video. I just want to say that I'm going to miss you all like crazy. You guys never fail to make me laugh and smile and literally, I don't know, just our crazy adventures, everything. I never would have imagined that I would be doing a theater or being on stage or singing in front of hundreds of people. Because I mean, when I was like, probably when I was younger, I was super quiet. I mean, I talked, but like, if you were like a really close friend of mine, then I'd open up and be like super like outgoing and super happy and all that. But going into high school, it's really like allowed me to kind of force myself to open up and be more outgoing and do things that I generally would be more uncomfortable with. But I never knew, seeing my eighth grade year, seeing Mary Poppins, that I would literally fall in love with theater and absolutely love it. I remember my mom had seen something like on Facebook and stuff to come and like watch this play, and that Andrean was hosting, and we didn't really like know much about Andrean. I didn't know anything about it really, like I've heard of it, but I didn't know like anything, like I've never been there or anything. And my mom decided to like take us to a show to see Mary Poppins, and so we went, and I was automatically like fell in love. Like after the first act, I knew that if I were to go to high school, I would for sure like do something like this, because it looked like so much fun and it looked beautiful and insane how people can put together such a beautiful masterpiece, musical production, whatever. So that kind of like catapulted my love for everything musicals and watching a bajillion movies and loving the world of acting and everything. So freshman year doing Testing, which is a comedy, which is hilarious, and I absolutely loved it. It was super fun. It was a little different than I'd expected, because a lot happened. Some people would know. A lot kind of happened there, but it was still a great show, and it was my first show, and I got to go to state for it, and it was super, super fun. Really amazing experience, and I got to meet a lot of people, and a lot of not just like people my age in my class, but also I got to form relationships and bonds with people who were seniors, juniors, sophomores, and to me that kind of wasn't what I had expected. But anyway, so that was like my first show, and Annie the musical, absolutely amazing. I love just staying backstage with like Bridget and who else, like I just like got closer with her. And it was just like crazy, just that whole experience was insane. And I had so much fun doing it. And of course I had to do it for the next 3 years of high school because I loved it so much. Although I would have to say that this year has probably been like the best year of my life. Like not just for school and like all the things I've been doing that I never would have expected in a million years to do, but just being around you guys and forming so many new relationships, especially over the Adams family. I think I've grown closer to a lot of people, and I absolutely like love you guys. Like you guys are like my family now. I don't know I regret not having that close relationship like a year ago and stuff. And I literally love you guys so, so much. And you guys never fail to make me laugh. And I love how I never know what to expect. Like every day I come to theater or go to theater or anything, like I always know I'm gonna laugh and I'm gonna have a good time. And just those memories are amazing and I'll keep them forever. Like, of course, everything Tech Week that happened for Adam's family, that was insane. And I absolutely had a blast. And just, I guess, singing in front of you all was a huge milestone for me. I didn't have the confidence I did probably a few months ago that I do now. And you guys are so supportive and super uplifting and positive and always have good things to say. And I really do appreciate it. And it made me feel more comfortable in myself and me as a performer, and I will forever be thankful and grateful for that. And I think this past like production that we put on just really taught me a lot of things and really just reiterated my love for theater and how I will actually, I think I'm going to continue pursuing it in college, so I think I'll still be doing that because I just had such an amazing experience and I want to continue it because I didn't want Adam's family to be my last show. So, although it won't be with you guys, the memories we've made will forever be in my heart. But I know that in the future, I will always stay in touch with you guys because I love all of you. And I can't wait to see what you guys do in the future, and hopefully I can come see everything and stay updated and stay with you guys as you guys continue doing future shows. And I don't know what else. I guess I'm going to say again that I'm gonna miss you all, and I'm going to miss everyone, and I'm gonna miss all the stuff we've been through and just how much fun I've had. And I really appreciate each and every one of you, and I'm gonna miss you all tons, really. Like, I don't know, I can't believe I'm like moving on and everything's gonna be changing, but I know that I'll forever like remember all the memories we've had together. And just I hope to like keep in touch with all of you because you mean a lot to me, and I love each and every one of you. And so I think I'm gonna end it there. Love you all. Bye. DJ Khaled. Hey. Yeah. All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough. And every time I step up in the building, everybody hands go up. And they stay there, and they say yeah, and they stay there. Cause all I do is win, 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 and if you're going in. Okay, I really hope the camera quality's okay. Hey guys, it's Bridget. Totally disregard the appearance and everything right now. I think it's like 11 o'clock at night, and I just got back from soccer a little bit ago, but I know this is important. I need to get it done. So I was involved in Andrean Theatre all 4 years, freshman, sophomore, junior, senior, and I did 3 shows, I guess technically 4 if you count Seussical, but we never performed those. So I was involved in 3 shows, and I would say kind of going into Andrean, I knew I wanted to do theater. I did it in the past when I was younger, and I was in a couple shows here and there, nothing super serious throughout my childhood. And then I remember when 2 of my older siblings went to Andrean, they both did theater and they absolutely loved it. And they were both kind of a little bit on the fence, especially my brother. He did it senior year and he really liked it. And then he got my sister to do it and she really liked it. And seeing how much they liked theater, and especially at Andrean, I always knew coming as a freshman,
I always wanted to do it, and it worked out well because I would be doing sports in the fall and winter, but then when spring rolled around, I'd have a little bit more time, so I always knew I'd want to do the musicals or whatever shows would be going on at Andrean during that time. So I feel like at first I was kind of apprehensive about it, but each year I did and each show I did it, I always loved it, and I was always glad I did. Especially Annie was my first show freshman year, and I loved it right away. It was such a fun group of people, and it was just always a lot of fun. So, one sec. Okay, so I would feel like one of the reasons I especially loved theater, really specifically Andrean Theater, is just because I always feel like it was always a good group of people. You know, it's not always the same people each time, and I kind of feel like it's a diverse group that varies, and that was really always awesome because, you know, you have freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors all together, and it's everybody from kind of all over the place, so I always really enjoyed meeting new people and getting to know everybody. I really liked that. I always liked coming in and not knowing some people or not seeing these people at Andrean before, and then coming into theater and having them do theater and getting to know them. That was always awesome. And like I said, I feel like it wasn't always just the same group every time. Each year I did the shows or did the musical, it was always a new group. So that was always fun, getting to be with new people and getting to do the shows with them and getting to know them. And I also really liked it because I definitely always feel like there's a family atmosphere there. And, you know, everybody was just super comfortable around each other, which I always really appreciated because, you know, I don't know, high school can kind of be overwhelming at times. And I feel like sometimes people are concerned about what others think or if you do something, and everybody would always be watching you. But with theater, you know, you come in, you can just be yourself and nobody's going to judge you, and you kind of just embrace it all. So that was definitely something I was always thankful for, is just always just being comfortable and being yourself around that group of people. I would say some of my favorite memories are, okay, I'll do each show. So Annie was my first show. That was a musical. Right off the bat, I loved that group of people that did it, because that was a bigger cast, I feel like, compared to some of our more recent shows, which that was pretty cool because I think there was like 40 or 50 people. I could be wrong on that. And so I really liked doing it just with that group of people. And then we would always go out to eat after the show, so that I love that so much. Like, we would literally be at Steak and Shake forever. I love doing that. And then so Seussical, well, we didn't do, but I Seussical was also a fun group of people, and the choir was fun there, so I liked that one. Almost Maine, I know not everybody liked it, but I did. Not that it wasn't a good show, I mean, just I know everybody wasn't a huge fan of putting it on, but I did really like doing Almost Maine, and I really liked how it was just completely acting there, and that was super fun. I did a scene with Pat Ricers, and that was really fun. I really liked my scene that I did with him, and it was a smaller cast that time, so that was fun. That was one of the times I was thankful. It was nice to just do a show with a smaller cast because I had done one like that before. And then with Addams Family, probably my favorite memory from Addams Family, I don't know, just the downtime when we would just be hanging out, or the times, I think, just meeting, because this was I feel like a different group of people than I've done the shows with in the past, so I really like that. I'm trying to think what else. Another, I feel like I'll always look back at Andrean Theater, and I'll always think of, I don't know why, but I'll always think of the warm-ups we do before the show, because I love doing those, and I thought Flea was so much fun. I love doing Flea and just all those warm-ups, because they changed each year, and Mr. K brought in a couple more new ones, so those were always fun, and I feel like I always liked those. And I don't know, I just feel like always looking back on Andrean Theater, it will definitely just be the people that will always stick with me. You know, like I said, my older siblings did theater, and they literally met some of their best friends in theater that they still talk to today. And I definitely feel like I've made good bonds, and really have gotten to know some people that I've really been thankful for, and just always meeting new people I've always loved, and going from seeing these people at school that you don't really know, or not maybe not even seeing people at school, to then doing theater with them and getting to know them. It's really awesome, and I really like how you gain a special bond with them. So that's really been awesome, and I just really think what I'll miss the most is obviously performing and just being yourself around everybody. You know, one of my other favorite things is I love the dance parties you would have, especially after the show. I love to dance, so those were so much fun. And I liked choreographing. That was fun. I got to do that. Well, I kind of did that my sophomore year, but, like, obviously this year, too. So that was really fun. But, no, those dance parties or those parties we would have after theater would be super fun. So that was all awesome. And I just think, looking back, it was just such, I don't want to say safe place, but that's what I'm going to use. I just feel like theater was a safe place where you could just express yourself however you wanted, do whatever you want, be whoever you want, and it was just always a good time. So I'll definitely always look back on it with awesome memories, and I want to thank everyone who's been a part of it and all the hard work they've put in, and everybody that does theater, because I think it takes more courage. Oh my gosh, I think it takes more courage than a lot of people realize. So I definitely will always be super, super thankful for my memories through Andrean Theatre. And I want to thank each and every one of you for making it the best, and especially making Adam's Family a really fun show to end it off on. Okay. All right. Bye, guys.
'Dog goes woof, cat goes meow, bird goes tweet, and mouse goes squeak. Cow goes moo, and frog goes croak, and the elephant goes toot. Ducks say quack, and fish go blub, and the sea.
4 years, 3 directors, and 7.5 shows later, here I am, filming my senior video. Bittersweet moment, I guess. But we'll just take back to freshman year with my first show, which was Annie. I joined theater just because I done some theater in middle school, but I didn't like join like right away freshman year. But I figured it would be a good way to make some friends, which I didn't have. So I joined Annie, and I'm not sure what made me go out for cast instead of crew, even though I'd only ever done crew stuff in middle school even. But I think auditioning for Annie in some ways was one of the best decisions I ever made. In some ways it wasn't, but that's what you get with anything, I guess. The last 4 years with theater have just been a very interesting, kind of crazy experience, I would say. Done a lot of things, made some friends along the way, I think, and I don't know, it's complicated, I think. If I was asked to make this video last year, I think I would have a little more to say, but it's not last year, because last year I was a junior, and junior videos aren't a thing, but I don't know. Theater has given me many things in my life over these last 4 years, and I've given theater quite a few things, I would think. I feel like I've dedicated a good portion of the last 4 years of my life to theater, which I'm happy I did, because I loved theater. It was always, you know, like my place to like come like be myself, which is what we all say, but it's because it's true. Theater just really taught me that, like, it's okay to be yourself. You just have to find the people that allow you to be yourself, which theater helped me find those people, and those people are all of you. You guys just all, especially you underclassmen, you guys are so like unapologetically yourselves, and I love you for it. I admire you guys so much, which it seems like I'm a senior. Wouldn't it be like, wouldn't it be like the opposite? But genuinely, I love you guys. Like, literally last year, I was like, I hope they think I'm cool. Like, I wanted you guys to think I was cool. I don't know if you do, but I think you're pretty cool, so. Yeah, which theater obviously gave me the opportunity to know you guys, which I don't think I'd be as close to you guys if I was in theater. I wouldn't. There'd be no way for me to. But that's why I do appreciate theater and all the time that I've put in, because I was given the chance to meet and become friends with all of you that are watching this. And that's something I always be grateful for, even if some of these like relationships fade or if we don't talk ever again. It's the fact that I got to know you, and you guys got to be a part of my life, I got to be a part of your life for at least a short period of time. And I appreciate that. I'm very thankful for that. I'm itching my eye. Sorry, I'm on like my 10th time of filming this. It's like 10 o'clock and I'm tired. It's past my bedtime. But that's what theater is. Staying up late and being sleep deprived. But yeah, I don't know. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. This is chaotic, but I'm not filming this again. So, I think the best thing that I've gained from theater is the relationships I've gotten. The relationships I acquired through theater in my earlier years, all of them were not good, except for one, and that was Zoe. Hi, Zoe. I love you. But the rest of the relationships I developed early in theater, not very good. So I'm glad I have the ones I do now. Like Marker. Or Meg, but I'm going to call you Marker because you're Marker. My adopted child. You're my mini-me. Whether you like it or not, you're a lot like me. And I love you. And Kennedy. You're one of the funniest people I know. So keep doing that. You're amazing. And I love your outfit. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Deal with it. And Eleanor, I love and adore you so much, even though you think I hate you, but I think that you hate me. But I don't know. I hope you don't hate me, because I don't hate you. I love you. You're great. Yeah. And then Josh, you're not an underclassman, but I'm still going to chat you out because you are chaotic and you are a great friend. And I love being like part of tech, like with costumes and stuff. You make me love being part of tech because of our little like side conversations of like, hey, we're being forgotten about, but I'm being forgotten about in this aspect. It's just always fun. You're just a really fun person. And I love that I've gotten to know you. And I love that through theater, we've been able to become a lot closer friends. And I never hated you. Stop thinking I hated you. I didn't hate you. We just sat next to each other in math for 3 years in a row. But I didn't hate you. I just have RBF. So, deal. And then Kaden, one of my newer friends. I hope we're friends. I think of you all as my friends. And I hope you think of me as a friend. Otherwise, that's awkward. But, Kaden, thank you for tolerating my nosiness. And always alerting Steven anytime you see me sitting behind the curtain. And then to my people, my last two people, Zoe and Steven, I love you guys more than anything. Theater's giving me a lot of shit. Theater's giving me some good things, but the best thing is giving me you guys. And I will forever be grateful for that. Because I love you guys a lot. And you have changed my life for the better. Definitely. So yeah. Even if I didn't mention any of you, just I love all of you so much. You guys have made such like an impact on my life, and especially this year, which as some of you might know has been kind of hard for me. But all of you have just made it so much better. Like, just being around you at rehearsals and being around you during shows is just, like, you all always brighten my day so much. And I love you all. So, to end off, I have two things that I've learned from theater. One is kind of a downer, but I've learned that no matter how hard you work for something, no matter how long you work for something, you're not always guaranteed that thing that you want. But that's okay. At least my therapist told me it's okay. I'm working on it. But I think it's something that is important to learn earlier, just so you're not so set on everything. But then the last thing that I've learned, which I already touched on, is it is so important to find people who make you want to be your true self. Never, like, change for anyone, obviously. That's something everyone tells you, but all of you are perfect how you are, and all of you are amazing and wonderful and so talented and funny and just amazing people, amazing young human beings. And I know all of you do great things, and I will miss you all so much. So yeah, I love all of you. Never change.
My anaconda don't, my anaconda don't, my anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun.
Boy Sway named Troy used to live in Detroit. Was the shootouts with the Lord, but he lived in a palace. Bought me Alexander McQueen, he was keeping me stylish. Now that's real, real, real. One in my purse, cause I came just to kill. Who wanna go?
Hello, it's me. Anyways, it's that time to do our video. To be honest, well, I'm outside first off. I like the nature. Everything. Anyways, I'm sure you guys are gonna say that's like a dad thing to say. I've put this off. It was due Friday. It's Tuesday now. I think part of it was maybe, well, some of it was some other reasons, but I might have been putting it off because like saying goodbye is hard, you know. But Just the thought, I know it's not goodbye forever, just the thought that my life's not going to probably cross with some of you guys' again. It's a little difficult, because you've been spending, you know, what, with pretty much all of you, it's been 2 years. I mean, I've done theater for 4 years, but, so the way I got started was, of course, my sister, freshman year, they had the theater call out, my sister, like, you're doing theater, and I'm like, okay, so I did it, and at first I really wanted to do lighting, like my bigger sister Anne did. So I did lighting, and it was a lot of fun my first year. I did spotlight, and then I helped set up the stuff, and I had no knowledge of how this stuff worked at all, none whatsoever. And it was a very overwhelming, but there was a lot more of us, so there was four of us doing lighting, so. Dedicated just totally to that, not to sound or anything. So now there's only like four of us doing everything, which is scary. After that, I think that next year they had me move to sound just because there wasn't enough people. So they moved me over, which was fine because it was interesting because my other sister did that. Most of you guys came in to the after COVID, we didn't do anything, and then most of you guys came into the picture, and I was pretty much left on my own to figure everything out, because there was no one that knew how to do anything. So it's a good life lesson there, kids. Pick yourself up by the bootstraps and figure out how to do things. So that's what I did. I got to meet all of you amazing people, and I'm just so surprised by all of your talent and everything, and especially the tech kids like Dom and Trinity. You guys really have a good understanding of what you do, and I really got to see you grow and understand the stuff that we do. I think that's the nice thing about theater, and especially the community we have now. I was somewhat close to the other kids, but I feel like the group we have now is a little more open, and it was I felt a little more free to express myself without having to get worried, having to be worried about getting made fun of or something. You know, and that's what I'm always really hyper conscious about, that, like, oh, is someone gonna make fun of me? Is someone gonna make fun of me for something? But I just didn't really feel that with you guys. You guys got to see me get a little crazy, I think, sometimes. So I really just wish you guys luck in the future. I have a lot of hope. After switching all directors and stuff, I think we have a lot of stability with Mr. K, and I think you guys can really bring the theater company back to what it was if we work hard.
Bro, she made fucking beans, macaroni and cheese. What the fuck?
I got that, but I got
more people in. And
hello, Regan Tony.
Going to St. Paul and stuff, and I'm really excited to see where your future leads. I promise you guys, I'm gonna come back. At least I plan to. Hold me to that, so I don't forget. I do plan on coming back because you guys are really, really like another family. I'm wearing my uniform, as you guys can see, because, like, I think theater has caused me to wear my uniform more than regular human clothes. Theater's like a second home because you spend those late nights there, and I'm just always there. My parents call me, "Where are you at?" "Oh, I'm just doing something for theater." It's kind of random. It's really a great place, and I feel like it has a stigma about it, on how, like, oh, theater kids are, you know, they're just weird or something like that, but it's really not that, and it's just sad to see that people think that, but it's really much more, you know, and like Mr. K always says, just shut off that those other people, because at the end of the day, what they say really doesn't matter, because as long as you're having a good time, you know, and you know you have these people to support you, it doesn't matter. You know, that's just one little comment that's in your way. Thank you guys. You guys have gotten me through some tough times, but really, you guys have really helped me. You guys have embraced me, I feel like, and I really encourage, you know, you guys to keep being you and keep welcoming people in, because you guys are some amazing people, and I'm excited to see where you go in life, because you guys will do some amazing things. I'll do a few shout-outs, maybe, because I think that's, like, tradition or something. I don't know. First shout-out is to Dom. Dom has helped me, well, Dom and Trinity. Dom and Trinity have helped me do the tech stuff. I remember the first time I got them in at the same time with Almost Maine. I said Trinity's sister came up and was like, she wants to do sound, so she was real quiet, and then I was like, okay, sit right there. So she sat there for all of Almost Maine. She was there, so it was good little support system. And then Dom has really taken over. I kind of stole him from Build, and he's really taken over the sound and embraced it, he's really bright, really bright kid. So I'm happy to see where it goes, and shout outs to some actors like Elena, Kennedy, Eleanor, Cynthia, and anyone else, and all my senior friends. You guys have really, like I said, been there for me, and I love you guys for that. So I wish you the best of luck. In the future, if you ever need me, call me. Just one call away. You guys know how to get to me, and I miss you guys. Big hug. Bye.
Senior video, take 23, mark.
No, deadass, this is definitely the 23rd time I've recorded this video. It is 3 a.m. It is the night before the cast show, and I am running out of time and mental and emotional stability. I really need to get this done. But I can't think of things to say in an organized fashion. I keep fucking this up. The last video I made was 22 minutes long, and it was just me dropping my emotional baggage on all of you. And if that's not a senior video, I don't know what the fuck is. Anyways, let's start off with some heavy shit. I found out that I was queer. I was a woman who loved other women when I was 12. I had gone to Catholic school my entire life, and I really hated myself because of my sexuality, because my religion, that's what they told you to do, was you pray that away. That's not real. That is a phase. God doesn't want that to happen, and if it keeps happening, you're going to hell. And I really, really hated myself, and that's when my mental illness really started to pick up. My depression got really, really bad, anxiety, which all amplified my ADHD, and it just made me think some really, really negative thoughts. And all of this was culminating from age 12 until I came in as a freshman, so 14. So for 2 years, this was all just bubbling up, ruminating inside. There were small things that made me become more comfortable with my sexuality, representation in TV shows and books and whatever, and eventually I came out to my parents October of that year. I then came out to close friends, and then it was just sort of whoever knew, knew, and I posted publicly that I was a lesbian. That following spring, during Pride Month, I believe. However, even though I was out, I was out at at a private school, a private Catholic school, and I received a lot of comments that were not necessarily kind to me about my discovery of my sexuality, which I learned to become was very beautiful and something that you should never be ashamed of. I was called slurs. I received horrible comments. I was called names. Just a whole bunch of stuff. And I told everyone that it never bothered me. It didn't get to me. You know, all these people were just closed-minded and stupid. But there's only so many times somebody can call you a slur or damn you to hell before it starts to take a toll on you mentally. And even though I didn't believe all of the homophobic stuff, it did cause me to sort of hate myself and my body and my personality and things like that. And I decided that I needed to be punished for that. So I did start hurting myself when I was a freshman. And it was something that I struggled with for a while. And I will say that I don't anymore. I learned that the scars are not worth it. And that you should never, ever, ever let anyone else dictate who you are or give you approval for who you love or who you want to be, because you are a beautiful person with a beautiful heart who loves whoever it wants to love, and that is a beautiful thing. Anyway, so I was in this really negative place. I was struggling with these negative thoughts of ending my life and harming myself to cope with that, and my saving grace really was theater. I just want to clarify that I was in theater when all of this was happening, but it was the developing of that theater family, that theater relationship, that really helped me get through it. And honestly, it didn't even develop until junior year. freshman year, it got slightly better. I had gotten into this romantic relationship. I felt loved for the most part, and it was not necessarily the best form of love, but it was what I thought love was and what I wanted, so I kept up with it. And then when I lost it, things got really bad again. Things got really bad my sophomore year. But junior year, after I had found my theater people through doing shows and taking classes and everything, those were my people. Those were my, if they were underclassmen, those were my kids. They helped me through, well, I say they, but it's you, I guess, because I'm talking to all of you now through this beautiful screen. Anyways, you guys were all my shoulders to cry on. I have really, really struggled with mental health for a really long time, and I am on medication, and I am working on it. But I genuinely don't think I would be here if it was not for Andrean Theatre. You were all very, very kind to me. Sorry. And you were all very accepting, and you made me laugh, and you made me smile, and you hugged me, and you did everything you could to take care of me. You gave me space when I needed it. You gave me jokes and surprises and shenanigans when I needed it. And I just want to say thank you for that, because I genuinely don't think I would be here. And now I am going to college for theater to hopefully be that saving grace for other kids who are struggling with mental health, who really find a refuge in theater and with their own theater families. And you guys are the reason for that, and the reason I'm pursuing that, and I want to go out in the world and change lives in that way, revolving around theater and mental health, especially in queer youth who think hurting themselves or ending their lives is the only solution. Theater is a safe space. It is a brave space for everyone to be who they are and love who they love and dance like nobody is watching. And I really, 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 really want it to stay that way. So no matter what show you do in the future, what role you get, whether or not you get cut from the show or you decide not to do it, you always, always treat people with kindness and respect and love, no matter who they are, what they look like, or who they love, or where they're from, or what they do. You always treat them with kindness and respect. Because it really does go a long way, and it went a long way for me, and I just want to say again, thank you for that. Some advice for you all. God, okay, hold on. This got serious. I didn't want it to. I'm so sorry. But it's also 3 in the morning, so you can't blame me. It's sad boy hours. I'm so sorry. Anyways, I just wanted to say how big of a part Andrean Theatre has really played in my life. It's been my home, and I hope it's home for some of you other people. And I hope you continue to make it home. And like I said, a safe space for people to be themselves. I am leaving. I didn't think I would be leaving. if you asked me freshman year if I thought I was going to make it to graduation, the answer would be no, because I didn't plan on it. And somehow I did it, and 4 years later, I am still here. Ooh, I'm all living in. I hate crying in front of people, okay? I am still here. I am still kicking it. I'm going to college. I'm going to college, and I'm going to get out of college, and I'm going to be a theater teacher, and I'm going to do theater. And I'm going to teach kids like me that it's okay to be themselves, and that giving up's not an option. Oh, God. Okay, I'm so sorry. Oh, so crying is taking up a lot of my time. God, I don't even... How does one recover from this emotional situation? I'm just taking a moment to, like, process everything, because I don't think I've processed it all yet. I just want to say that I love all of you, and that you've all done so much for me, whether you realize it or not, and that I will always be grateful for everything you've given me. Even if you didn't realize you were giving me something, just jokes, laughter, dancing, memories, videos, pictures of you doing something fun and having fun and sharing joy. I just want to say thank you for that, because your joy is one of my favorite things, especially as an upperclassman, is watching these underclassmen really be themselves and find their own way. Is that's just a really beautiful thing, and I'm very excited to be an educator and be one of the people providing a space for that. And I wouldn't be in that position without you guys. So I am going to stop crying, and I'm just going to say thank you again, even though I said it 50 times. I'm going to say, I love you very, very much. I'm just, last thing, I promise, I swear. Queer kids, whether you are out or closeted or still figuring your shit out, Eleanor, baby, potentially. I don't know, that's why I said figuring your shit out. I just want to say that I'm very proud of you. No matter how old you are, what grade you're in, I'm so proud of you for making it this far. And I just want to tell you right now, you can keep making it, and you are going to get out of high school. It is a bitch to get through. Believe me, it sucks ass. But you're going to get through it, and you're going to get to college. And I am not there yet, but I've heard wonderful things about the queer community. In my college, actually, the place where I am living, my dorm is called the Rainbow Floor, and it's literally just a floor of dorms filled with homosexuals. So it doesn't get any gayer than that. So believe me, once you get out of this very small, closed-minded Catholic environment, you are going to find a world of allies and friends and romantic partners and possibilities. And it's going to be a really beautiful thing, and I'm so excited for you all to see that and to make it to that, just like I did. All right, with that, this is 15 minutes. I am so sorry. Anyways, this is senior class of 22, Zoe Irving, signing off. Thank you, Andrean Theater. Keep making that Andrean Theater magic.
Bro, she made fucking bang.